You would not believe how warm it is out here. I had to go grab my sunnies, but I'm back. It's a new art vlog. Welcome. Today, we're starting Peachtober. If you saw my last art vlog, you'll know that I wrote down all the prompts for Peachtober and did a quick sketch next to each of them. Okay, let's go through the prompts before I melt. The first prompt is B. I'm going super simple here. I'm thinking just a nice intro one. We're going to do a circle that's like a really light wash of yellow, and then we're going to draw a bee on it. I'm sorry, I know that's basic, but I want to get the hang of the inks first. I'm going to do a couple of really simple ones to start off with. The second prompt is Cosmos. Cosmos? We're going to be painting a galaxy because they're fun. The third prompt is sweet. For this one, I had the idea of doing a young girl and her hair is like in the shape of a sweet wrapper. I just thought that'd look really cute. Number four is grub. I really wasn't sure about this one, but in the end, I've just gone for something really simple. I'm gonna do an apple and a caterpillar. Number five is sprig. I really struggled with this one, so in the end, I've gone for a cute dog that has like a sprig of rosemary coming out of its head. Number six is eye, and for this one, I'm gonna do an eye in the shape of a heart. Seven is crater. Now this one I'm probably going to change. At the moment I've got like an overhead shot of a meteor or volcano crater that's like a smiley face. I don't like that. I didn't like it when I did it. I'm going to replace that, I think, for a dinosaur. When I think of dream, I think of like a bed and a teddy bear and nighttime. So I decided to go for a teddy that wants to be an artist. Number nine is blue. I've already done blue before. I did it for mermaid. This time I'm thinking, again, we're going to do negative space, but I'm going to do it underwater with a whale. Number 10 is citrus, and I thought of a lemon boy. Next is pencil. Ants collecting a found pencil, and there's ant holes in the background. Not sure why I went there, but it'll be fun. Next is nest. I've already done nest. I did that for Inktober. So this time, the baby is going to be slightly older, and it's going to have its eyes open. It's going to be a bit more like a toddler, because it's like a year's past. After that, we've got ship. I just thought of doing a really kind of abstract 2D landscape. Number 14 is garden, and honestly, I might change this one. A gnome holding a shovel. Then we've got weather. I'm gonna do a layer of yellow and pink, and then I'm gonna do black on top, and it's gonna be like a cloud and lightning. Then we've got sidekick. I don't know if this one will stay, but at the moment I've got a robin. 17 is blush, and I was just gonna do a cute child that's kind of cartoony, really obvious blush. This next one will probably change quite a bit, but I've got snooze, and I've got quite a cluttered bedroom, and there's an alarm clock, and it says no. The next one will probably also change. I've got a campfire in the woods and there's a candle instead of the fire. You can tell I was running out of ideas at this point. Then we've got bulb. I was just gonna do a light bulb with a landscape inside. It's a little bit surreal. 21 is slingshot. Honestly, I had no clue for this one, but in the end, I've just kind of put a target in a landscape. Then we've got tunnel. I just thought of a train in a tunnel, but I quite like the way the bricks go into a triangle. Then we've got message. This one's a little bit of a cop-out. It's literally just a message in a bottle with a cute frame. The next one is wand, and I've literally just got a hand holding a wand. Almost there. Number 25 is coral. For this one, I'm thinking of just doing a simple underwater scene with negative space, but I'm gonna do colors this time rather than just one. Then we've got ladybug, and the only thing I could come up with at that time was literally a ladybug on a leaf. Then we've got pond. The only thing I could come up with was a fairy and a mushroom kind of reflected in the water. Then we've got chomp, and I thought of a crocodile. Number 29 is float, and I think I'm gonna do a jellyfish. Then we've got moss. I thought of doing a overgrown castle with a load of moss, but the frame is also kind of moss. I thought that could be fun. And the very last one is spooky, and I love that the prompt for the 31st is spooky. At the moment, when I run out of ideas, all I had was a negative space graveyard with ghosts. That one's gonna change. A lot of those are gonna be changing, but those were the initial things I thought of. I've got a little bit more editing to do, and then we can go in the Cardi sketchbook, get all the drawings ready, and then we can begin. This is the current situation. My partner was trying clay for the first time and we've mixed this brown shade up and there's so much. There's also some greens and yellows. It's just acrylic paint, but I didn't want to throw it all out, so I've ended up filling all these pages in my sketchbooks and I have no clue what I'm gonna do with them. This is the setup that I've got. I've put all my inks on this cloth because I don't trust them, ink stain. I've got a couple of waters, I've got a few brushes, but I know this one splatters quite a lot, so I don't know how much I'm actually gonna use that one. I've got a plate and then I've got this. This went so wrong, but I have faith. I might be able to fix it. And I've got this sketch. And then this one's gonna be a galaxy. This is what I'm planning to do for my first day, the title page and two entries. I'm not going to go too much harder than this, I don't think. Let's get started. Here's where I'm at. I've done the title page. It's kind of here. I really like it. I'm now on the B and I've encountered slight problems already. This yellow is so much more yellow than I was hoping, and I'm not really able to get any water blooms. I think it's the paper type. So I think I'm gonna have to actually mix in a little bit of either blue or pink to actually make the bee a slightly different color, because if I just put the yellow on yellow, I don't know if that will really work. I think I need to add a slightly different color. This is the yellow, but it doesn't actually look like this. I mean, I virtually used all of the pigment here, so I think I need a slightly different color, but this is how it's going. Oh, that's the first day done. I don't think they're amazing, but I'll show you what I created. This is the bee that I did. I decided to do this spontaneous pattern on the outside because there was a little bit of yellow here that leaked. So I decided to do that. And this is Cosmos. I mean, they're very different. The galaxy was interesting. It went different to what I'm used to, but I got some of these lovely textures. So in the end, I decided to not go with the idea I wanted with like really big stars. I did like a really thin line and I didn't do the black edge like I was gonna, because like, look at that. I don't know if you can see, it's so pretty. These textures, so nice. And I also did this random bee with the ink that was left on my brush and then the ink that was left on this glass dip pen. And this is what I made, a spontaneous bee with what was left on my brush and pen. Tomorrow, I'm gonna attempt to do three so that then on the third day, I'll just do the two. I don't think it'll be too hard because today I did do the title page as well, so I did technically do three, but honestly, like, my back hurts. I'm tired already and it's the very first day. I need to sketch out the next three prompts and then chill for a little bit and then we go again tomorrow. I finished the third day and that's the first week of prompts. I painted this eye in ink and it only took about 10 minutes. I did wet on wet and I decided to just leave it like that. I really love how it's turned out. I also did this adorable little dinosaur. I know I didn't check in yesterday, but it all kind of went to plan. I had some leftover ink after each one, so I've done like a little loose background. That one's gonna have a strawberry on and that one's gonna have a pear on in gouache. Oh, that's still wet. I did this random page, which is gonna take forever to dry, but I thought it could look really cool. I might pop something on it. I also did this, which was kind of cute, and I did this with leftover ink. I just didn't want to waste anything, so this is what I got done. Hi there, it's the final day of week two, so I thought I'd have a little bit of a check-in. I really should have checked in earlier, but honestly, like,
Week two is not strong. Day one, I wasn't in a great headspace, so I just didn't really create anything good. And then the second day, I didn't have much of a plan. I did the sketches on the day, which is really what I wanted to avoid. I really hope this day goes well, honestly, because otherwise the video is not going to be great. If you saw any of my Inktober videos last year, you might have seen this one. This is Nest. The prompt Nest is in Peachtober again, so I'm thinking of doing the baby, but a little bit older this time around. So I'm literally going to do the exact same kind of thing, obviously on different paper, so it might react differently. And the baby's going to be older. I thought that'd be really sweet. So that's what I'm doing. It's kind of like an homage to last year. I don't know. We'll see how it goes.
Like, you can't really tell what on earth that is, but we'll see if I can fix it.
And that's week two all over now. I did three very different styles, but I really like how they've turned out. I'll show you.
This is garden. I used gouache and did a kind of illustrative style, and it's still a little bit wet. But I did sort of Caran d'Ache Neo colors, and then obviously I remade the baby, and I'm really happy with that one. I had some leftover black ink, so I just did this cute little thing. I also painted that blue just because I had some leftover blue. I did this with leftover ink on my brush, and I did this with leftover ink on my brush. So I just did a couple of little sketchbook pieces as I was going. But yeah, that's been a successful day. I feel like I probably took a little bit too much green off, really. I didn't know how much to keep, and it just doesn't look very full now. It's looking a little bit bare, so I'm not sure. I took everything off that's like above this, and I took a couple of extras off because it looked a bit crazy, but I don't know, it's a bit bare.
I haven't checked in a few days, so I thought I would. I'm now starting the final week of Peachtober.
With the random bits of ink that were left on my brush, I painted these random stuff. This is kind of like wherever that is that I got from Stationery Pal. I also did that. I don't know. I had ink left over. I wanted to use it. I'm really happy with what I've done so far. So these are kind of from last week, but starting the final week now, I did this, which is really simple. It's a little bit wonky. It's a bit imperfect, like in lots of ways, but I do quite like it. I have this one, which I do like it. I think I like it. I like the color pencil accents. And this one's slightly crazy. I sort of half wanted to do like a scribbly background on the entire thing, but that's a little bit bold and I don't think I'm gonna risk it. But so far, I'm doing pretty good, honestly.
Like, I've not got anything incredible, but I'm really happy with the progress that I've made so far. I also had a slightly exciting package, which shouldn't be exciting in the slightest. I got this tiny little glass screen protector from my camera, so I get to pop that on. My last one broke, so I've literally been using a film one, and I didn't have the right size, so I had to cut it, and you can see it looks awful. So I'm really excited now that I've got the glass one that I can pop on.
This is not coming off, honestly. I don't want to damage the screen though, because I am using tweezers, but I'm really struggling to get this off. I'm going to have to ask my partner too, because I don't want to ruin my nails. But yeah, this is kind of welded on.
I think I've just done my favourite piece of Peachtober so far. Honestly, sorry, I haven't got any makeup on. I just really want to show you this piece that I've just done. The prompt was Flow, and honestly, this is the perfect combination of ink and gouache for me. I really love it. I really, really love it. And it was such a simple design, but I think I did it so well. I'm so happy with it. That's one of my favorites. The finish line is completely in sight now. Tomorrow is the last day. I've got Moss, which is kind of like a castle I'm doing. I've got an idea though. I've got a pretty solid idea for that, so hopefully it'll go quite well. The last one is a pair of lips. The prompt is spooky, and I'm gonna do like some vampire lips, and they're gonna look kind of hot. I haven't shown you everything, and I haven't vlogged very much because honestly, like, every day is kind of the same. I'm kind of doing the same stuff. And if you're interested in the actual Peachtober work, then I will leave the playlist here and down below so that you can check that out. Obviously, every single piece is in there, so I don't really see the point of like showing it on here. But for the behind the scenes, honestly, I'm really tired. I had a pretty good plan going forward, which was
like to do it in week sets. So it's a 3, a 2, and a 2. And then for the final week and a half, it's like a 3, a 3, a 2, and a 2. But honestly, I'm so tired. Like, I'm really, really tired. It's not even 1 yet. So I'm probably going to edit some of my artwork and add it to InPrint. That's what I would like to do. I would also like to update my YouTube banner. That one's been there a long while, and that was in a time when I didn't know anything about Photoshop, so that banner's not good. I would really like to make a new YouTube banner, one that actually says how regular I post as well. I don't know if I'll be able to manage that today, but tomorrow is the last day of Preachtober. Then I think probably about 3 weeks later, I'm going to be doing a sketchbook tour of... Everything will be up by the time you're seeing this art vlog. Honestly, I'm so many art vlogs behind that by the time you see this, like, the entire 4 weeks of Peachtober, the sketchbook tour, they'll all be up. So I'll leave them all down below if you're interested. But yeah, I'm really close now. You can just see in this sketchbook, it's like almost half. Yeah, I'm really happy with how it's going. I'm tired, but I'm really happy with how it's going.
I want to try the easiest and most kind of authentic route for the banner. So this is the idea that I've got at the moment. I just took a photo, and it might work, it might not. The idea is the banner will basically be like here. It's focusing on my hand. The banner will be a tiny little strip. So it kind of goes flowers, eyes, neo colors, flowers, jellyfish. Probably that ink won't be in, and then a little bit of paint. I don't know if it'll work, but I want to try and do a banner in a really genuine way for me, that it literally looks like it is, kind of like all the videos on my channel. Also, I don't know if I Photoshop everything individually and then pop it on. I don't know if that will really work. I don't know if I have this skill set. So I'm going to try this currently.
I've kind of made the prototype for what the banner could look like, and I'm really quite happy with it. I might redraw these if I do choose to stick with it. This is how it will look on the screen. It's actually only this tiny area here that will be on show most of the time. So that's why I had to like do it so wide and so long just in preparation for it. And unfortunately, there is a fair bit that does kind of get cut out, like, eh. But honestly, I'm quite happy with it so far. I'm gonna see what my partner thinks, but I think this might be it.
Good morning, it's a little bit later, but I'm now gonna get started on the final day. I've got my pajamas on because it's absolutely freezing. Before starting Peachtober, I'm gonna start filming a little bit of a tutorial. I've got an idea to paint a underwater scene. So I'm thinking today I'm just gonna film a little bit of the intro and popping the sketch and the masking fluid down, so then tomorrow I can get started, because it's gonna be quite a big lump of masking fluid. And I'd have to wait for it to dry tomorrow, so at least now I can wait for it to dry overnight.
Accidentally dropped my iPad case, so I've tried to super glue it back together. I don't know if it'll work, but I thought it's worth a shot. This is what we used.
It's done, finally. It's 4 o'clock and I haven't had lunch yet, so I'm gonna go do that. Like, it's still wet, but I mean, it's kind of okay, but considering how long it's taken, I'm not really happy with it, but it's over. It's over, Peachtober's over, and I'm so happy that it's over. It took me, I wanna say 14 days and I had 1 day off. It was hard, but I'm kind of ahead of the curve. I need to get all of the content ready, but I should be able to chill for October now, because we are still in September and I finished the challenge. So October, I'll be able to be online. I'll be able to post on time. I think it was worth it. We'll find out.